Today we're taking a look at Lively Wallpaper, which is a free and open source application that's designed to bring your desktop to life by setting animated and interactive wallpapers on your desktop. So basically you can set videos as desktop backgrounds, and you can also choose some other wallpapers that's interactive, meaning when you move your mouse or when you press certain buttons on the keyboard, the wallpaper actually responds to that. So Lively Wallpaper can be downloaded from many locations, including its own dedicated website. And as you can most probably see on the website here, it won the Microsoft Store App Rewards in 2023. So it is a highly rated application. But we're going to download it and then test it out, and I'll show you some of the features that you can use to customize your Windows desktop. So clicking on the download button, we've got two download locations, either from the Microsoft Store or we can download the installer directly. But just so you know, it is also available on the Microsoft Store and it's got a 4.5 star rating. So once you've installed Lively Wallpaper and you've launched it, this is the screen you'll be seeing. The first tab is the library tab, and basically here you have some preset options from wallpapers that you can choose from, and there's 12 at the time of this recording. Now most of these wallpapers here are interactive. So as you can see from the first option here, which is called Fluids, it reacts with the system audio and your mouse cursor. So if you want to set one of these wallpapers, you can just click on it, or you can click on the ellipsis menu next to it, and then you can set it as the wallpaper. So I'm just going to click on the wallpaper, and then it's going to set that wallpaper as my current desktop wallpaper. So you'll see as I move my mouse, this wallpaper reacts to it. Now, something very important I want to mention to you guys is at the time of this video recording, the latest version of Windows 11 is 24H2, and I actually had some issues during this recording getting these live wallpapers to work. So how I fixed the issue of the wallpaper not displaying was by right-clicking on the desktop and then going to View and then checking Show Desktop Icons. That made the wallpaper appear when I selected it, because my desktop icons was turned off. But now you can see, even if I toggle off Show Desktop Icons, it still works and the wallpaper is still displayed. But just for some of you that might run into the same issue on Windows 11 or maybe even on Windows 10 as well, I don't know, the fix for me was right-clicking the desktop, clicking on View, and then showing the desktop icons. But you can see I don't have any desktop icons anyway. But moving on, like I said, you've got these preset options here. So if you're in the mood for rain, you can select the rain wallpaper, and then you can see this also interacts or moves as I move the mouse, although the droplets don't interact with the cursor itself. So these are some preset options, like I said, and you can go through these on your own time and set one of these preset options if you're into one of them. I'm not going to be showing you every single one in this video. I want to go through some of the other features that the application has. So something I want to draw your attention to is this button right here. If I click on that, it says two active wallpapers. Now I've got a dual screen setup. I've got two monitors, and you can see currently it's set to duplicate. So this wallpaper is set on both monitors. I can change the placement method to screen one only, which is then only shown on my main monitor, and the other monitor has my default wallpaper that it had before. Or I can span it across multiple screens, so the wallpaper is stretched or enlarged to show on both monitors. So this will also help you if you have widescreen monitors or if you have more than two monitors even. The point is you have some settings that you can set with regards to how you want these desktop wallpapers to be displayed. I'm just going to set it to duplicate because that's what I had before. And then you also have this option to always pick the screen when choosing a wallpaper. So if you want to use this option that says always pick the screen when choosing wallpaper, then you'll have to choose the screen setting, and then you can select either one of the monitors and then select this option and then click on OK. So what will happen now is if I choose another wallpaper, it'll prompt me to choose the display that I want to show this wallpaper on. So you can see currently I already have the rain wallpaper on my primary monitor, but if I choose the second display for the other wallpaper that I just selected and we go to the wallpapers here, you'll see that display 2 now has a different wallpaper than display 1. So if you want to have different wallpapers, different live wallpapers on separate monitors, you can do that by using this setting. So let's say that you don't want to use any of these preset wallpapers. You can actually set your own wallpaper. And to do that, you can click on the plus button here that will give you the option to add a wallpaper. Then you can either simply drag and drop video files into this section here, or you can click on this button to choose a file, and then you can select a file that's saved on your computer that you want to have as a video background. Or you also have the option of entering a URL from a web page that you want to have as your desktop background. So let me show you what that looks like. If you come over to YouTube and you just do a search for animated wallpaper, you'll find a bunch of different results. You can see most of these are 4K or Ultra HD. Then you can choose any video on YouTube you'd like to use for your animated wallpaper. So I'm just going to choose one of the top results here and then pause the video. And then I'm just going to copy this URL by pressing Control C. Then I'm just going to paste it into this field here. And then I'm going to press on this arrow button here. And that's going to load the video. Now you can actually give your wallpaper a title. So let's just call it abstract. You can enter a description if you want, fill out the author field, and then the website link you'll leave as is. So I'm just going to click on OK. And then that video I got from YouTube will be set as the animated wallpaper. So you can use this for different things. Let's say we want to have something like a car that's driving. I'll just copy this link as well. Then I'll just add a new wallpaper, paste the YouTube address in there, and then press the arrow button. Again, I'll just call this Supra and then click on OK. It's going to load the wallpaper. And now I'll have this nice Supra that's driving endlessly as my live wallpaper. Now, let's say you don't want to use a YouTube video as your desktop wallpaper. You want to use another video. Maybe it's a video you took yourself, or just another video file that's saved on your computer. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to download a video from Pexels, and Pexels is one of the most popular free stock photos and royalty-free images and videos websites. So I'm just going to search for something simple like a looping animation. I'll just select this looping video. And then I'm going to click on the download options, and the highest resolution this is available in is Full HD. So I'm just going to download that. But this website also has 4K videos. I'll just save that in a directory that I created for Lively Wallpapers. So I created a Lively folder in my videos folder, and that's where I'll save that video file. So now back in Lively, you can add a new wallpaper, and then you have two options. You can either choose a file and then navigate to the file, or you can just drag and drop it from the window here, and then you can give it a title if you like. I'm just going to leave it as is and then click on OK, and that's going to load the wallpaper, which will then set it as the desktop background. So now you can see the desktop wallpaper is set to the video that I downloaded and then add it to Lively Wallpaper. Now I'm just going to change this back to the raindrops for now, so it's not so distracting. So the next thing I want to draw your attention to is that there is a gallery tab, but it just says coming soon. And I guess the developer will still implement a gallery here where you can choose from live wallpapers that's hosted by other people, and that's not part of the application like these ones. If we click on the settings icon, here's where we get to a whole bunch of other settings, and I won't be able to go through every single one in this video. It's just going to take too much time, but I will highlight some of the most important ones. So you can have Lively start with Windows. Then you have an option to set the system tray icon, which is the icon that you have there. And I recommend keeping this on so you can always get to Lively Wallpaper easily. Then another important setting is if you set a video, whether that be from YouTube or a file that you downloaded as a wallpaper, and that video has sound, the sound is going to be constantly playing and it might be really distracting. So that's why you have this audio tab here where you can control the volume level of all the wallpapers. So I'd recommend just setting this to zero so that you don't hear the sound from those videos that you set as wallpapers. And then for those of you that's concerned about performance, there is a performance tab here. And if you click on it, you'll find a few settings like pausing the wallpapers when an application is full screen. So for example, when you're gaming, the wallpaper will be paused so that it doesn't take any other resources while you're gaming. Then you can also set the same option for when an application is focused. So these are already set by default to the recommended values. The same for laptops. When you're on battery power or when on battery saver, what you want Lively Wallpaper to do in both of those cases. And then you also have an option to pause it when you're using a remote desktop. And then the display pause rule, you can pause the wallpaper on all screens or only the screen that the application is focused on. So basically only the screen that a game is running on or a resource intensive application is running on. Lastly, you can go to application rules and then you can add specific applications so the wallpaper will be paused when you run these specific applications. Then next in the wallpaper tab, you have some other options here where you can control the input, the ways that you interact with the wallpaper. You can choose the mouse, the keyboard, or you can turn it off completely. You also have some options choosing the video player that you want to use for the video wallpaper, and if you want to use hardware acceleration. And you also have options with regards to what's being used when you set a wallpaper using the web browser or a URL. And then lastly, you'll have an app exclusion list for music. So you can select apps to exclude from showing music details. So if you're using one of these wallpapers that shows the music that's playing on your computer, you can set apps that will not display the music on that wallpaper. Now, lastly, if you're wondering how much resources this is using, if I open the task manager and we have a look at what's running, currently it's using almost 1% of my CPU. If I close the Lively Wallpaper window and it's just minimized to the system tray, you can see on my computer here, it's barely using any CPU. It's actually using no CPU at all at the moment. And then with regards to the RAM, it's about 90 to 100 megs of RAM that it's using while it's running in the background. So that's really not a lot of resources that it's using to display these animated wallpapers or these interactive wallpapers. And the application is a really lightweight application. So that's how you can use Lively Wallpaper to customize your desktop with animated or video wallpapers. And I hope this video has been useful to you. If it was, please give the video a like, consider subscribing to the channel. As always, I want to give a special shout out to all of my YouTube members. Thanks so much for your support, and I'll see all of you guys soon.